all throughout the Grand Canyon. Here's that hour-by-hour forecast for tomorrow, starting off that marathon in the low 50s, so might be a little chilly. Warming up very quickly, though. We'll be at 73 by 1 o'clock. Then we're going to hang out in the mid-70s across the valley. It's going to be a nice day. 75 the high for tomorrow, but a little breezy. We'll see 75 on Monday, and then 74 for the high Tuesday. A cool down is in the works. We'll talk about when we can actually see that, how cool we'll get coming up at 6:30.
Which rideshare service do I use to get around the valley? We put the Smart Shopper team on the case, finding the best option for your time and for your money.
This is Chad, our photographer, and this is Quina, our producer. Chad had Uber and Quina had Lyft. I had Yellow Cab.
We're traveling from our studio to Camelback Holiday with different rides to see who's going to get there first and have the best price.
Sanders and Ford.
Quick timeline for you. ASU basketball. 12-0 start in non-conference play. Best start in school history. Then Pac-12 play begins. And they've lost three of their last four. If they get back on track today, Devils welcome the Oregon State Beavers to town. Oregon State, a team ASU should beat. But once again, they do not make things easy on themselves. Their best player, Trey Holder, 1-for-8 in the first half. He also had 4 turnovers. But the good news, despite Holder playing that poorly, the Devils were only down by 1 at the half. Bad news is, the Beavers poured it on in the second. OSU comes up with all the momentum of the half. On the Devils, Cody Justice finds the one leg move. Huge jump there. ASU comes back, holds off the Beavers 77-75 in the final at Wells Park Arena. Same matchup to be drawn State, Oregon and Arizona down in Tucson. The Ducks upset the Sun Devils 2 nights ago. They're going to do the same today against the Wildcats. You know what? They come close. But the Wildcats do what they've done for many years now. Find a way to win. Oregon has the lead with 3 minutes to play, but U of A rattles off an 8-0 run. They hang on. Alonzo Trier leads the way with 25 points. DeAndre Ayton with 24. Wildcats win it 9-83.
It was a huge win, especially because Oregon is rolling right now. They had a big win out of Phoenix when they beat ASU. And we didn't want to lose because we had to protect our home court. Especially because last time they came out here, they beat us.
You know, I thought this afternoon might have been our overall best win of the season. We have immense respect for them. We knew that it was going to be a heck of a fight, and it was.
So the Cats avoid the upset. They're now 4-1 in conference play. Next up, they'll take on the Cal Bears Wednesday night in Berkeley. All right, let's talk some football. Arguably the greatest weekend of the NFL season. The divisional round of the playoffs, which means a double feature on both Saturday and Sunday. Hope you got your chores done early. Let's start things off with the Battle of the Birds, and what a battle it was. Falcons and Eagles, Atlanta takes the lead in the second quarter as Matt Ryan finds Devontae Freeman. But the Eagles have a kicker, the rookie Jake Elliott. It's 3 straight field goals. Philly takes a 15-10 lead, and it comes down to 1 play. 4th and goal, Falcons. For the win, Matt Ryan hucks it up. No good. Eagles hang on, 15-10. And they're heading to the NFC Championship game for the first time since 2009. And finally, it's a sad day in the world of sports. We lost a legend, Keith Jackson, the voice of college football. One of the most popular play-by-play personalities in the business died Friday night at the age of 89. It's a long list of broadcasting accomplishments for Jackson. Way too many to list. But he was the first play-by-play voice for Monday Night Football when it debuted back in 1970. And Jackson was also credited with nicknaming the Rose Bowl the granddaddy of them all.
They had a lot of catchphrases, too.
Yeah. Whoa, Nelly. Anytime you hear that on the highlight, Keith Jackson. Yeah. President Donald Trump in the middle of a racial firestorm after reportedly making those vulgar comments about African nations in Haiti. What do you have to say today? The unique response from one postal.
A phony delivery guy pulling a very real gun on one homeowner. The man's wild tale was started with a knock at the door.
Welcome up. Slow on. If you're driving with a small child, they're supposed to be buckled into a car seat. But what happens when you call a rideshare service? I need to see the team investigating game this morning, and I want to undercover to find out just how often rideshare drivers are breaking the law. Go around with Katie and Amelia and I to see who's willing to put children like her at risk. Just for the ride. That's Monday. Only an ABC Good Team is at 10.
Get ready for a healthy dose of flavor. With our product was only under 500 calories in a week. Fire grilled chicken gets super strong. The new flavors of the double chicken chip plate and the strip avocado plate with brown rice and spinach. Fresh from the deal. It's 2018. Your last chance to save big on 2017 Nissans, including Altima. Featuring Nissan intelligent mobility with automatic emergency braking. It can help you stop safely.
Thank you.
Haiti and Africa.
Yeah, in a tweet, he blamed Democrats for the collapse of a bipartisan deal that would let immigrant children stay in the U.S. That issue was discussed Thursday inside the Oval Office. ABC's Daria Albinger reports.